لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، ما لنا رب سواه.
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا، ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار، صدق الله العظيم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, beloved viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and ahlan wa sahlan, and welcome to our program. Let us begin our program with our dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant all of us sawman maqboola wa iftaran shahiyya wa amalan mutaqabbala, and may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accept our ibadah in the month of Ramadan, and may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant our beloved marhumeen Jannatul Firdaus. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وسكنهم في الجنة، اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وروحهم في الجنة، رب ارحمهما كما ربيانا صغيرة. Brother and sister in Islam, this is just a few days passed, and we are in the month of Ramadan, and we enjoyed the first 10 days of Ibadah. Many of our friends, they are celebrating that Mubarak, a blessed month of Ramadan, and our children, our family, our relatives, our brothers making dua for us, and we make dua for the ummah inshallah. Shahrul Khair, the month of goodness, Shahrul Ghufran, and we know the first 10 days of Ramadan, we call it awwaluhu. Awwaluhu, the first 10 days of Ramadan, maghfirah. Maghfirah, it means forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then in the middle of it is rahmah, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the other 10 days. And the last one is called itqum min an-nar, to free yourself from the adab of nar or adab nar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the barakah of the first 10 days of Ramadan, which is forgiveness and kafara and maghfirat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My message today to our beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, that be careful of your nafs in the month of Ramadan. Because we know that shaitan being locked and chained, and there's no shaitan in the month of Ramadan. Some ulama said there's only the small shaitan, but the main shaitan are locked, and so fidat, it means chained in the month of Ramadan. We have one enemy with us in the month of Ramadan. It's not shaitan, but it's our own nafs, that desire, or that our own habit. Brother and sister in Islam, we know that Ramadan is shahrul khair. But we know also that a'da a'da'uka, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, that the worst enemy ever we have in our life is a nafs. That eye, or that desire, or that inner. Brother and sister in Islam, there is knowledge. It's called ilmun nafs, the science of the nafs. Quran al-Kareem mentioned the nafs 115 times. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did warn the ummah about nafs. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala spoke about nafs, that kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. And he spoke about wa nafsin wa ma sawaha fa'alhamaha fujuraha wa taqwaha. So be careful of that nafs, because many of the people who committed a mistake or our shortcoming in the month of Ramadan because of the nafs. That nafs is a test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is ghafoor rahim, Rabbul Alameen granted us that Mubarak month of Ramadan to cultivate and behave that nafs. We know that the worst enemy ever we face is the unseen enemy. If I have a physical enemy in front of me, I know how to deal with it. I can call someone to help me and to deal with him because I can see him. But shaitan and nafs and all that type of creation which is invisible, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala did ask us to seek protection in him, in Allah. A'udhu billahi. For example, hasad, envy, jealous, enmity. You don't know what the people are doing against you. So you need Allah tabarak wa ta'ala unseen to fight and protect you from the unseen dangers which come to us. Brothers and sisters in Islam, amongst the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah created me and you to be his servant. Amongst the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant us so many ways and means to come closer to him. Amongst the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he did warn me and you from any act or any action takes us to his anger or his punishment. We know that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created insan fi ahsani taqwim, created insan in a best form, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala treated insan as his dependings or as his beloved creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made Adam as khalifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to agree, me and you today, that Allah created us and brought us to this dunya not to punish us and to torture us. It's to let us enjoy this life and also to go to him. The proof of that, or the evidence of that he sent thousands of prophets, besides that agreement, me and you, we done it in the world of the soul before Allah created us, that he gave us the da'wah. So that's called Ahdu Dharra, the Atom era, which me and you did agree and make covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will worship him. Alastu bi Rabbikum, am I not your God? So, brother and sister in Islam, we do agree that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves me and you. That's why he gave us so many ways to come closer to him and to avoid fire and to avoid his anger. Allah did not create me and you to be punished or to let me be punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Forgive me, honor me, bring me closer to him, and grant me his best reward in the day of Qiyamah, company with our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We learn from Adam alayhi salam. Adam alayhi salam, he is a beloved one to Allah, the first creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know that Adam alayhi salam got only one command of Allah in Jannah. One command: do not eat from the tree. Who gave Adam alayhi salam this command? It's Allah directly. It's not going to him through the prophet or angel or anything. It's just from Allah directly to Adam. But because of nafs, because of shaitan, because of the nature of human being, that Adam alayhi salam forgot not the command of Allah, forgot that there is enemy with him in Jannah. It's called shaitan and nafs. So many people said Adam forgot and ate from the tree. He said, no, Adam did not forget the command of Allah, but he forgot that with him there is enemy, the shaitan, Iblis, or his own desire and his own nafs. That's why Adam ate, alayhi salam, ate from the tree, and he regret, asked Allah forgiveness, and he became a prophet. So the problem that for those people, all of us, we are sinner, that you have to believe that Allah is waiting for me and you to come back to him, to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the person passed away, we say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We belong to Allah, and to him is our return. Yes, because this is our permanent place, Jannah. With Allah, this is our taqdeer, our final destination is to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we were there before. The other thing, me and you, we're receiving the taqwa of Allah naturally. So we born good. We born Rabbani, innocent. We call him child heart, innocent like a child. Yes, we born with no evil. We born with no sin. We picked up It came to us, so it means temporary. But the origin, the foundation of the Muslims or the human being is to believe. That's why it's natural to come back to Allah. It's not hard for me and you to come back to, I always say to my friends, back to factory setting. Factory setting, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Any ideology, any bad thought, any bid'ah, any problem we have is not ours. Someone gave it to us, we pick it up, we forgot, like Adam alayhi salam, not forgetting Allah, we forgot that there are some enemies around me and you, nafs, shaitan, people in our society and our life. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is tawwab. When we talk about tawwab, it means he's exaggerating in his repentance. It means it's not once or twice, many times. If I ask you now, how many times you commit a sin, and how many people committed a sin, and how many times Allah called them, Hayya ala salah and Hayya ala falah. Definitely, he's tawwab, because quantity and quality, he did sort it out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala practice his quality, tawwab, upon all of us, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters in Islam. And once again, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this opportunity to fast the month of Ramadan. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, grant us the khair and barakah and generosity of this Mubarak month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the reward of Laylatul Qadr. Ameen, thumma ameen, wa rabbal alameen. Brother and sister in Islam, again we remind me and you that we are the ummah, that the beloved ummah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because he is the beloved Nabi to Allah, and definitely Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will never disappoint Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the day of Qiyamah. And we do believe, we have hope and fear. We have hope and fear because fear that we did not fulfill the haqq of Allah, and we got a lot of hope that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will never disappoint our beloved Nabi Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the day of Qiyamah in all of us. When we talk about the tawbah, the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is most forgiving, that he is mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem about the Ramadan. He said, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. So that message is for me and you. We have Ya ayyuhal nas, O you people, and we have Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Ya ayyuhal nas is general, it's for everyone, Muslim and non-Muslim. But Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you believe. Believe in who? Believe in Allah. Believe on his messenger, believe on this Quran, believe on the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So me and you, we are the believer, and we did accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as our Lord and our God, so we have to follow what we believe. So, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you believe, kutiba alaykumus siyam. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said that siyam, fasting, prescribed upon you. It means I have to call you to the month of Ramadan. I made it farad for you because I need you to benefit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most high example, that if you think about the mother or the father or the teacher when he forced the students or the son to study or to take medicine or to do certain action. It sounds hard, it sounds controlling, but in reality it's benefiting the students. He will pass and he will get some good job and he will get some pleasure on that study. Or the son, when he take medication, who eat certain food, he will gain some health, or he will get something better. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is all-knowing, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala alimun khabir. He's all aware about our condition. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala forced me and you to come to him 5 times a day to be washed and to be forgiving. Yes, brother and sister in Islam, kutiba alaykum as-siyam. So Allah prescribed that fasting for some wisdom, as we see. How many people return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of Quran? How many people Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala changed their title from hypocrisy, from sinning, to Jannah and Iman, and qualified himself to enter the heaven or the Jannah al-Firdaus. How many person, because of the month of Ramadan, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has placed him in his behavior and his manner and attitude? How many people, they were very far from Allah, even they were cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but because of Shahru Ramadan, Shahrun Kareem, the generosity of the month of Ramadan, they return back to Iman, return back to Hidayah. And that's why you say, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Once you fast the month of Ramadan, you are a believer. According to this ayah, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Been prescribed upon you. Not to struggle, not to feel hungry. It's to be washed, to be forgiving, and that. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the day of Ramadan come, futihat abwaabul jannah. That message, it shows me, the hadith of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it shows me and you how Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is kareem, and he gave us shahrun kareem, and Quran kareem, and Nabi kareem, and you are also kareem. When we talk about futihat, the doors of Jannah, futihat, we have in Arabic futiha, and we have fut. With the tashdeed. When we say futiha, it means open halfway or little bit. But futiha, it's in exaggerating. It's just a certain word. It shows that how this door widely open, usually open the door by Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah ordered the door of Jannah to be open for me and you. That also shows me that what a lucky person, the one who passed away in this Mubarak month. Definitely will enter Jannah, inshallah. According to this hadith of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, futihat, impossible for that person, the one who passed away in the month of Ramadan, that he go to anywhere else besides Jannah. Why? Because Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the next portion of the hadith, وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ, that the door of Jahannam shutted and locked. We see غُلِّقَتْ, if you read in Surah Yusuf, that the wife of the king of Egypt, وَغَلَّقَتِ الْأَبْوَابُ. There is a big difference between to shut the door like this and to lock it in so many hatches, or I don't know what you call that, locks there. It means sometimes when you lock your door, the car door, you just pull it this way. But when you ghallaqat, you have to press so many buttons to make sure that no one besides you can open this door. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala used this two wonderful Arabic words in the hadith of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that futihat, open widely, no one can close it, wa ghulliqat, shut it, locked, no one else can open the door of Jahannam to take the Muslim who passed away in Ramadan to Jannah. That is to fire. That is shows me and you that those people who miss their beloved one, those who look around the table and don't find their beloved one, they say where they are, we see inshallah, by your dua, the dua of billion of Muslims, the dua of the fasting people, that definitely Allah will open the door of Jannah for all the marhumin, and that is our wish and our hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Impossible for those who pass away in the month of Ramadan to experience any adab, because Allah wanted like this. It's Shahrun Kareem, very generous Kareem. The other thing also, in the month of Ramadan is indeed is Kareem. Salah, your salah, we calculated when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala fulfill his promise in our salah in the month of Ramadan, you gain 3 million reward a day. If you practice your salah, nafil salah, and salatul tarawih, if you bring it together, 3 million reward a day. Times 30 days, you see now how many million of reward you get. So what a lucky person, the one who knows how much reward Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will give, so that he can encourage himself and the other to look after this ibadah in the month of Ramadan. Quran al-Kareem, if Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give you a reward for each and every letter, so you read one para, one juz, you gain a million reward. For one para, you gain a million times 30. Look at this. Look at this. The other thing also, Salatul Taraweeh. Salatul Taraweeh, which me and you, we think is too much. It's too much. We said no. Salatul Taraweeh, you become from Ahlul Ihsan. What is Ahlul Ihsan? The people of piety. When you read Salatul Taraweeh, you brought yourself to the list or to the group of the people, we call them Ahlul Layl or Ahlul Ihsan. Ahlul Layl, the people of the night. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ahlul Layl ashrafu ummati. The people of the night are the noblest one amongst the ummah. So you become very special. Actually, you gain the level of the family of the descending of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first night of Ramadan, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the first day on Ramadan, Allah look at the people on earth, those who are fasting, look at you personally. So subhanallah, when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala look at you, when we talk about look, we say subhanallah, the way he look, and when he look at you, the person who received that looking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never be punished in Jahannam. La yu'adhibuhu abada. That he will never experience any pain or any adhab. I just want to prove to you that we are the luckiest ummah. We are the fortunate ummah because we gain such unbelievable reward in the month of Ramadan. That's why definitely, definitely, Ummatul Islam are very pure and very salih in the month of Ramadan. Can you believe that while you are fasting in the daytime and you are not fasting on the nighttime, the 24 hours day in the month of Ramadan, the entire angels, malaika, are making istighfar for you, making dua for you. I'm not talking about the angel of Laylatul Qadr, the night of the power. I'm talking about the normal angel. How many angels Allah created? We don't know. So, how many dua you gain? And dua of the angels definitely accepted, making istighfar. Brother and sister in Islam, we are lucky in the month of Ramadan. Ya Allah, grant us the dua of malaika in the month of Ramadan, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brother and sister in Islam, welcome back to our program, and ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah Rabbul Izzat tabarak wa ta'ala grant us the barakah of Shahr Ramadan, barakah of Quran, and may Allah grant our parents and our marhumin Jannatul Firdaus. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah accept the dua of the billion of Muslims around the globe for all of us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant rahmah for each and every Muslim who pass away, and may Allah grant rizqun halalun tayyib for each and every Muslim who want to live halal and he want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before the break, I was talking about how much Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give us in the month of Ramadan, but unfortunately some of us, we deal with Ramadan as a normal month, a normal ibadah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant me a new understanding of this Mubarak Ibadah in the month of Ramadan. In the month of Ramadan, any good deeds, now I don't need to name it, any good deeds, Allah will accept it as a farad. You did do farida for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the compulsory thing or the ibadah like this. Farida, when you practice your farida, like you fast or you make salah, zuhur, fajr, or any salah, Allah will write it as a 70 farida. So those people who need to increase the reward of them, come and practice good deeds. When we talk about any khair, any goodness, tabassumuka fi wajhi akhika sadaqa. To smile on the face of your brother is a charity, is good deeds. Brother and sister in Islam, yes, this is a time of farming with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is investment. In this Mubarak month, you will find yourself gaining a reward min haythu la tahtasib. from somewhere, he will never know about it. The title of the Muslim in the month of Ramadan, Malaikatul Bashar, the angels of human being. You are not eating like angels, you are not drinking, you are not, inshallah, we are trying not to do evil. So you become Abdan Rabbaniyan. You became a Rabbani, a servant of Allah. That me and you in the month of Ramadan, we exactly, inshallah, we hope that a copy of الصحابة في رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أن أخلاق النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم تعبد الله كأنك تراه. You worship Allah as you see him. They call it مراقبة. مراقبة, when we talk about مراقبة, that you mind your words, you mind your eye vision, you mind your thinking, you mind your heart, you mind your hand, you mind your foot, you mind, you become عبدا ربانيا. To worship Allah as you see him and he sees you. The other thing which is very important, that we are the people of amanat. And just such a sensitive amanat in the month of Ramadan. Amanat of our eyes, amanat of our tongue. You are such a concerned person, the person who worry about his thought, his eyes. So we call you Amin. And you know Amin is a trustworthy. So you take the title of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he was as-sadiqul amin. As-sadiqul amin, the trustworthy. Brother and sister in Islam, yes, you are in the month of Ramadan taking one quality of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Dua, you have two duas a day, definitely is accepted. One dua in the daytime, one dua at night. So brother and sister in Islam, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala gave me a new blank check or blanche check, you call it. You just put any amount you want. So be wise, be clever, and change your dua every day. You have two dua, one in the day, one in the night, and the time of iftar. So try to make a different dua for yourself so that you can gain. Imagine that population of Muslims are making dua to another, and Allah accepted the dua of the ummah. Because we see that we're receiving the dua of the ummah, the Imam of Haram asking Allah for each and every Muslim. Allah give him lil mu'mineen wal mu'minat, wal muslimeen wal muslimat, al ahya'i minhum wal amwal. The other thing also which is very important, brother and sister in Islam, that when you help someone to break his fast and to eat sahur, you gain three people's reward a day. One for you, one for iftar, one for sihri. So imagine that you duplicate your Ramadan. So you see now you already gain three Ramadan this year. To stop sinning in a month of Ramadan, Allah will write you amongst mujahideen. We call it jihad on nafs. All of us, we run away from jihad. But there is a small jihad here, come and do it. It's called mujahideen. Brother and sister in Islam, yes, we are the people of Jannah, inshallah, in the month of Ramadan. I'm not saying that just to entertain you. That is a hadith, ayat from Quran al-Kareem, proof that this shahrul karam, shahrul ihsan, shahrul khayrat, shahrul rahma. The first of the 10 days of Ramadan is maghfirah, you washed. And then rahmah, mercy from Allah, and then itqum min an-nar, you free yourself from the fire of Jahannam. Now you are newborn after the month of Ramadan, and many people gain the pleasure of Allah in the month of Ramadan. And we're talking about how much reward we get. But what about the month of Ramadan is shahrul fadl? What is fadl? Fadlum min Allahi wa rahmah. So when we talk about fadl, that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala said to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنَّ لَهُمْ قَدَمَ صِدْقٍ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give glad tiding to those who believe. Remember when we begin our program with the أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, believe that they will have قَدَمَ صِدْقٍ, they will have a surprise in a day of Qiyamah, a good surprise in a day of Qiyamah. What is that surprise? The payment of Allah or the reward of Allah هذا شفاعة في نبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم which we call it الفضل. So many علماء they ask us to read this دعاء in Ramadan. Oh Allah, when you question me in the day of Qiyamah, don't question me because of عدل, justice. I don't want my fee payment. I want فضل. اللهم لا تحسبنا بالعدل بل حسبنا بالفضل. That فضل, that the word فضل, it's a favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the grant of Allah. واسألوا الله من فضله. Ask Allah his فضل. You know what is فضل? You will get a reward, unbelievable reward in the day of Qiyamah. When lady gave the dog a drink of water, she entered the highest status in Jannah. A dog? Yes. Why? Fadl. In my simple English, I can tell you this one. Someone did help you just to carry that box from the car to your house. Few steps just pass. And how much you pay him? Imagine the person just take $1 million and give that person. That man will go mad. Why? I can expect the 1,000 or 5,000, but that is, yes, so he become mad. That person, in the day of Qiyamah, there is qadama sidqin, there is a big surprise for the Muslim. And tell the person he won't believe, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kareem, and his giving also is when Allah tabaraka said, I will give you, you mustn't put it according to my capacity and your capacity. You must talk about the qudrat of Allah. وَاسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ. Say, by the favor of Allah and his mercy. فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا. You must feel happy. You must wait for that favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. It's better than what you're waiting for. Giving, grant, reward with no payment. Subhanallah. Reward, you did not give anything, you did not do any work, and it's not your right. You just favor like that. You say it's just extra check, as they say. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala spoke to the husband and wife in Quran. He said, after you get divorced, which you're shaking the arsh of Allah, and there is some cases that people get divorced. وَلَا تَنْسَوُ الْفَضْلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Do not forget the favor to one another. I know the court give you this. I know the Sharia give you this, but we need fadl. We need extra payment, because Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, تَخَلَّقُوا بِأَخْلَاقِ اللَّهِ. Behave like Allah's behavior. Take the manner of Allah to give like this. So don't say he doesn't deserve it. No, I did give what is written, what is in the book. I said, no, I'll wait for the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the day of Qiyamah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will call some Muslims to let them stand up to be exclusive, to be special. فَلْيَقُمْ أَهْلُ الْفَضْلِ. So the people of fadl must stand up. Come closer and come forward. What fadl, fadl. So the angels asked them, what fadl you do? He said, no, we used to make sabr. We used to be patient. We used to have tolerance. We have to swallow the anger for the pleasure of Allah. How many times? We can't remember. Like if you ask your mother, did I trouble you when I was young? She would tell you, yeah. How many times? Oh, too many, but I can't remember, because the mother always make sabr, and she got fadl for the children. The Nabi Muhammad said, "La yadkhul ahadukum al-jannah bi'amalihi." No one of you enter Jannah because of his deeds. They asked Nabi Muhammad, even you? He said, even me. Illa an yataghammadani Allah bi rahmatihi. Unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompass me, cover me with his mercy and his fadl. In this Mubarak month of Ramadan, ya Allah, grant us the fadl in dunya and akhirah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us khayrul dunya and fadl dunya and akhirah. Short break, we'll continue after the break, inshallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, ya Allah, do not deprive the ummah from the khair and barakah of Shahr Ramadan. And once again, we remind all the Muslims who's watching us now, do not forget that you have a very special moment in the month of Ramadan. Do not miss that one. You have missed so many opportunities, but there is that opportunity come closer to you in your lifetime. So do not miss it. Plus, don't forget the hadith of Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam when he was climbing the minbar and he said, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. So the Sahaba asked him, Ya Rasulullah, why you have mentioned the three Ameens now? So Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Jibreel Alayhi Salaam came and cursed three people and I agreed with him and I said, Ameen. What is the first one? The one who did witness the month of Ramadan and he could not achieve Jannah because such an easy way to gain rahmat of Allah and forgiveness of Allah. The second Ameen, the one who did live with his parents, witness one of his parents, and he did not gain Jannah. I cannot imagine a Muslim got parents and he didn't gain Jannah because of them. And the other one, the last one, he said that he heard the name of Rasulullah and he did not reply Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because once you make Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, immediately you have the response of Allah, Ulaika alayhim salawatum min rabbihim. Allah will praise you and Allah will forgive you. Brother, sister, Islam, we have a golden chance now in the month of Ramadan. Be wise, be realistic, be clever, love yourself, invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and work hard in these remaining days of Ramadan. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant me the ajr of the month of Ramadan and the fadl of the month of Ramadan. The other thing, لِكُلِ الشَّهْرُ الْإِحْسَانِ, the month of Ihsan and piety. When we talk about the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Ramadan, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that he is not unfair to any creation of Allah, even the non-Muslim. Inna Allah la yudi'u ajra man ahsana amala. Allah does not waste the payment of any person who's doing a good deed. We heard that so many non-Muslim doing some good deeds. They got welfare, the humanitarian aids and helping what and feeding and what. That is good deed, but they will get payment in dunya because they don't believe on akhirah, so they believe on dunya. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the qima. What is qima? The proper value of their act. Allah bless their children. Allah give them health like that. So there is payment, it's called qima. The other thing is called iwad. Iwad, replacement, compensation. Many people miss something. You lost your beloved son, your husband. You missed some thought of ni'mat of Allah. You make sabr. Allah definitely will compensate you in dunya before he compensate you in akhirah. We got a thaman. Thaman is cash. Ma naqasa malum min sadaqah. And that anyone who pay cash for the pleasure of Allah, we ask Allah to reward him in akhirah, no problem. But there is cash in dunya. That the tabi'i, the pious person, used to keep 2,000 dirham in his hand, and he gave the people. The wife asked him why he is coming back. Impossible to give any charity or zakat or any physical payment, and then you miss it and you lose it. It will come in any type of form because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala promised that he will give. The other thing is called wafa. When the wafa, it means fulfillment, to give that a full amount. You will never get shortage of your payment. You will receive that payment that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala yuwafihim ujurahum. Allah will fulfill incomplete, the perfect amount, in full amount, that payment. So never, ما نقص مال من صدقة, that your wealth will never decrease when you pay the charity. The other thing is called إيتاء. In Quran, they call it إيتاء الزكاة. No, إقامة الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة. You know what is إيتاء الزكاة? The person who decided to pay zakat or charity or sadaqah, definitely he is generous person. Because the word is called ita, It's heavy. It's a heavy action. Like, imagine a person is working and he made money and he took from his halal income 2.5% and give it away to someone, maybe he's not his family who doesn't know his name. That, it's a great work, because those people who pay zakat, that's why Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he set up an army to fight those who stop to pay zakat. And we see nowadays people pay millions of dollars as zakat. To who? To some people, they don't know their names. Their money move around the globe because he believes in the ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, it's the haqq, the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other thing is called ajr. Ajr is wages. That is for ibadah. You fast Ramadan, you get this. You make salah, you get this. But that ajr here fall under condition. Like you hire someone, you come and paint my house, come and dig my farm there. He said, okay, you have to dig it so much like this. You have to do it like this from 5 to 8. So a certain agreement. That ajr, or that pay year, that payment day, you have to fulfill the agreement. Your salah, Allahu Akbar, you have to do it with khushu' and ruku'. You have to do it as Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. So many people waiting for that wages, they say, wait. You're not sure that you did fulfill the payment or the work to Allah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will pay you, but under the condition of, that's why you said many people, they get excited when they make salah and say, alhamdulillah, but did you do it as Allah wanted? That's why we said ajr, it depends on the condition of that act or that work. The other thing also, hajj, Ramadan, and like that. We waiting for the fadl of Allah, that favor, that surprise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That type of ajr, we got so many ajr. Right? If you fulfill the command of Allah as is, which all of us we are trying, but we will wait for the ajr of Allah. That inna Allah la yudi'u ajra man ahsan amala, you will get your payment. Cash, because by making niyat, you get it from Allah. Number two, ajrun ghayru mamnoon. Will never cut off, will never stop. So now it's like sadaqah jariyah, running charity. We have ajran hasana, beautiful payment. Anyone who receive it will never be jealous of other payment. You know, when we talk about hasan, rabbana atina fi dunya hasanata wa fil akhirati hasana. What is hasana? Hasana, it means a payment. You will never look at the Jannah of someone else. You know, yeah, when we build a house, we check our next door. Oh, you look at the food of someone. You say, no. You will be, hasan, it means you will agree, you will be happy with it. The other thing, it's called ajran kareema, a very generous reward. That reward which you receive, it will be sufficient for you and for your offspring, your children, the next generation. And we do see the taqwa of the parents comes to the many generation. And we read in Surah Al-Kahf, the two Nabi came to build a wall for a children. The father was very pious. Ajran kabira is like Laylatul Qadr, a very huge payment in the day of Qiyam. Ajran bighayri hisab, uncountable reward. Brother and sister in Islam, Allah is Kareem, Ramadan is Kareem, Nabi is Kareem, Quran al-Kareem is Kareem. You are the servant of Allah in the month of Ramadan. You have to be Kareem, generous. Kareem in your ibadah, Kareem in your sadaqah, Kareem towards the Kareem. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala stretch his rahmah in the month of Ramadan. Please come and cover yourself with the rahmat of Allah. Receive the rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brother and sister Islam, we know inshallah, the entire ummah will enter Jannat al-Firdaus. We believe that we are here, are the fortunate person came ever on this earth. Why? Because we follow the deen of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we are waiting for the intercession of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Gain the fadl of Allah. Put your hand forward and receive the fadl of Allah. places, Makkah, Medina, Masjid, you gain the fadl. Times, Ramadan, Yawm al-Jum'ah, Salatul Fajr. People, ulama, anbiya, gain the fadl of the people. Practice the sunnah to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My humble request, sisters, you are the manager of your family. Be the means of your family to come and make Ihya'u Layali Ramadan, to revive the iman in your house. Fill your house with dhikrullah. Encourage each other to have sabr in the month of Ramadan. Clean your heart. Clean your heart to receive the taqwa in the month of Ramadan. La'allakum tattaqoon. You may have the piety in your heart. Brother and sister in Islam, we have done so many things bad. And let us receive the rahmat of Allah. Let us start to reconcile with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this Mubarak month. I promise you that you will feel the difference. And this Ramadan will be different than the previous Ramadan because of that clean heart which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted you in this Mubarak month. Unfortunately, our time is up. We'll continue inshallah next time. Shukran jazeelan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Iftaran shahiyya. صوما مقبولا وعملا متقبلا. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accompany all of us to eat ta'am and food with our beloved Nabi Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam في مقعد صدق عند مليك مقتدر.
ربنا رب القلوب وهو علام الغيوب في الشروق وفي الغروب نوره يهدي العصا. ربنا رب القلوب وهو علام الغيوب في الشروق وفي الغروب نوره يهدي العصا. ربنا الهادي الودود.